According to the Food and Agricultural Association of the United Nations, every year, one-third of the food that's produced for human consumption goes to waste. That's one-third of the fruit and veg, one-third of the grains, one-third of the meat and dairy, one-third produced with the intention of feeding people, but instead going to waste. And more often than not, going to landfill. Organic waste, which includes food waste, represents the largest proportion of the overall waste stream going to landfill in New Zealand every year. Now, food waste, when it decomposes exposed to oxygen, such as in a composting situation, decomposes aerobically. And through that process, we can create a nutrient-rich substance that's good for the soil and good for the environment. But when uneaten food is left to rot in a landfill, it decomposes anaerobically without oxygen. And that leads to the creation of harmful leachate and greenhouse gas emissions, both carbon dioxide and methane. Studies estimate that if global food waste were a country, it would be the third largest carbon emitter behind the United States and China. And the environmental impact of food waste doesn't just happen at that final decomposition stage. Think of all the resources that go into creating that food in the first place. Planting it, harvesting it, transporting, storing, preparing, wasted electricity, wasted water, wasted time, wasted human effort, effort intended to feed people, but instead resulting in one-third going to waste. Now let's look at another set of circumstances. Here in New Zealand, 1 in 7 households live in poverty. 1 in 7 households experience hunger and food insecurity. When people are struggling to pay the rent, pay the bills, transportation, medication, food is often the first thing to give. And nutrition suffers when finances are tight. In New Zealand, there are children going to school every day that are hungry. Here in the Waikato, 25% of the students arriving at school in the lower socioeconomic areas of our region are arriving with some form of food need. Maybe there wasn't any breakfast, or there's nothing for lunch. Might not be any dinner either. Think about it. The Waikato is one of the largest food-producing regions in New Zealand. And yet some of our people struggle to provide a basic healthy diet for themselves and their loved ones. So on one hand, we have one-third of the food produced for human consumption going to waste. On the other, we have 1 in 7 households in New Zealand experiencing hunger and food insecurity. Can anybody see an answer there? Should be pretty simple. Piece of cake? Not always. This is the story of Kaivolution. Kaivolution is a food rescue service provided by the Waikato Environment Centre. Kai being the Māori word for food, and volution. Evolution, revolution, transformation, morphosis, change. Now, what we mean by food rescue is that we rescue edible food that was otherwise destined for landfill. So we collect food from a variety of sources that, while it may not be good enough to sell, is still certainly good enough to eat. And we distribute that food to people in need throughout the region. Now, some of this food might just be surplus to requirements, Maybe there was a bit too much bread baked that day, or might be nearing its sell-by date. Other food might just be slightly outside of a particular product specification. So maybe the pies were left in the oven a little too long and the pastry's gone just a bit past golden. Or the baby carrots weren't harvested early enough, and so now they're too big to be called baby carrots, but they're not quite full-grown carrots either. But the pies are still edible, and the carrots are still healthy vegetables, and neither belong in landfill. Kaivolution took its first donation on the 29th of October, 2014. Those early days were full of challenges. While we had the support of a few key funders, it was still uncharted territory for us. Would the donors get involved? Would there be recipient organizations that could make good use of this food? Did we have enough space and volunteers to make this operate efficiently? We had one old freezer and one old fridge. Did we really know what we were getting into? In just over a year and a half of operation, Kaivolution now has two vans, a cool room, packing and sorting tables, and we have rescued over 125 ton of food. We collect food from 43 different organizations, from supermarkets to cafes, wholesalers to growers, and we distribute through 63 different charities. We're reducing the carbon footprint, or the foodprint, as we call it, through a reduction in over 200 ton of greenhouse gas emissions. We collect information on the types and amounts of food that are collected, and we feed that information back to our donors so that they can become more efficient, produce less waste in the future. From fruit and veg to bread, dairy products to canned goods, Kaivolution's rescued food has produced the equivalent of over 350,000 meals. Let me tell you the story about our first donation. We got a call from Bidvest, which is a local wholesaler. They said, "We've got a bit of broccoli. Do you think you could use it?" A bit of broccoli turned out to be 100 kilograms of broccoli. That's about 20 of these boxes. Now, these were early days for Kaivolution. We only had a couple recipient organizations on our books, and we had nowhere to store this broccoli. But we weren't about to turn it down. So we gave 20 kilograms to the Hamilton Combined Christian Food Bank. We gave 50 kilograms to St. Vincent de Paul. We still had 30 kilograms of broccoli. So we called an organization that we'd worked with previously, a local social services group that, amongst other things, provides early childhood care and after-school care for struggling families. And that day, every child went home with a head of broccoli. Now, I will be the first to admit that maybe not every kid would be that excited about being handed a head of broccoli. But what you need to understand is that for some of those families, that broccoli would have been a nutritious addition to what might have been a pretty meager meal. And for some other families, that broccoli might have been the only thing for dinner that night. 100 kilograms of broccoli, feeding people in need, and not going to landfill. One of the biggest challenges at Kaivolution is we never know what we're going to get. While we have a number of regular donors, we will also get large one-off donations, crate loads of kiwi fruit, or pallet loads of meat pies. And our challenge with limited storage space is how do we get these foods out to the organizations that can make good use of it? One time we were donated 100 kilograms of garlic. Think about that. How long would it take you to go through 100 kilograms of garlic? But as luck would have it, shortly after that, we were donated 10 ton of tinned Italian tomatoes. See, some of our recipient organizations have large commercial kitchens, so they can turn tinned tomatoes and garlic into a number of different nutritious meals. Or they can take a slightly bruised fruit and turn it into delicious crumble. Other organizations need individually packaged, ready-made meals for their clients. At Kaivolution, it is a huge jigsaw puzzle. But somehow, every day, we manage to make the pieces fit. Kaivolution has led to other forms of resource recovery. We got a call from a local orchard that was culling some trees, perfectly good fruit trees, just surplus to requirements. So burning up the phone lines, calling in heaps of volunteers, 70 pear trees were relocated so that they now bear fruit at Kindy's, on Marae, and in community gardens across this region. Since taking our first donation, the growth of Kaivolution has been phenomenal. We collect and distribute food 6 days a week. We have over 65 volunteers, and we are literally bursting at the seams. Every day, we get calls from more recipient organizations, more donors that want to come on board. We have a waiting list of 4 supermarkets waiting for us to have more capacity. All those early questions we had, would the donors get involved? Would there be recipient organizations that could make good use of this food? Did people need this service? Clearly, we have our answer. The need is great, and at times, it seems unending. A common challenge for nonprofits is the inevitable conundrum between availability of funding and an increasing service need. Do you curtail your growth despite the need, or do you have faith that you will always find enough resources to allow you to continue to do your good work? At Kaivolution, finding adequate financial support is always going to be a challenge for us. But like so many nonprofits, we are eternally optimistic. So many of the environmental problems that we hear about in the media today can seem so enormous. Rising sea levels, increased global warming. The challenges can seem so huge that it can be really difficult to see how you or I as an individual, could have any impact. Against those sizes of challenges, the default is often non-action. The problem is just too big. It's too hard to fix. It's easier to do nothing. But our efforts don't have to be huge to make a difference. Local action does create global change. So maybe food rescue is something that's meaningful to you, something you can get behind either as a funder or a volunteer. Or maybe it's choosing to buy local or ethically recycling your electronic waste or taking your own bags to the grocery store. And when you're at the grocery store, maybe you think about how much food you're buying. Do you really need 5 carrots, or is 3 enough? There is something that each and every one of us can do. Remember, no action is too small. It all has an impact. Through Kaivolution and the Waikato Environment Centre, we're reducing waste to landfill. We're feeding people in need. We are making a difference. And together, we can all create change for good.